I think I've seen this look before. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Odile. I work as an art director in the beauty industry, and on my channel I talk about the latest trends and insights in Korean beauty. So if you want to be the first to know about what's trending in K-beauty, don't forget to click the subscribe button and hit the notification bell. In today's video, I will share with you the top 5 Korean beauty trends from the 1990s that have been recently making a comeback in K-beauty. This is the second episode of a series where I talk about the history of K-beauty. And if you haven't watched the first episode where I covered the history of Nature Republic, click here to check it out. I'm sure many of you will recognize this scene from the Korean drama Reply 1988. Reply 1988 is a TV series that follows the struggles of five working class families at the end of the 80s. It became a huge success in Korea because it captured the importance of human relationships in our everyday lives. And after the airing of the show, many people started to long for a past where people used to come together despite the economical, social hardships they were going through. Suddenly, young people developed a fascination for anything old or vintage, and this resulted in a trend called Newtro. The name Newtro combines the words new and retro, and describes a tendency to revisit old trends from the past and give them a modern twist. In the past couple of years, we've seen this trend take over almost every aspect of Korean pop culture, from music to fashion to films and even beauty. For this reason, I thought it would be interesting to explore how beauty trends from the 1990s are currently shaping contemporary K-beauty, and also tell you a little bit about these trends and how they started. But without further ado, let's get right into it. Trend number one is dark lips. Dark lipstick is perhaps the most defining Korean beauty trend of the 1990s. It's something radically different from the natural look we associate with K-beauty nowadays, so you might think that this trend is inspired by Western beauty. But did you know that Korea was actually one of the first countries in the world to start the dark lipstick trend at the end of the 1980s? During the Seoul Olympic Games of 1988, Korea was introduced for the first time to the Western world as a developed and modernized country. If you look at the documents or videos from that period, you will see that many women sported wine or burgundy lips. So Korea became known to the Western world as a country where women wear heavy makeup. Lips kept getting darker and darker in the following years, until in 1992 the Amore Pacific group launched a truly iconic ad campaign that would end up defining the rest of the decade. The campaign was produced to promote Amore Pacific newly launched brand Mamond. It was the debut of Lee Yong-hae, who worked as the face of Amore Pacific until 2001 and later went on to become one of Korea's biggest top stars. The brown-colored lipstick that she wore in the ad immediately became a huge hit in Korea, selling over 2 million lipsticks in the first month. Following this craze, dark and brown lipsticks became very popular amongst Korean actresses. Top stars like Kim Yesu or Shin Min Ah were seen wearing dark lipstick in magazines, talk shows, and primetime TV dramas, inspiring a generation of Korean women to imitate their look. For example, here you can see Kim Yesu in an interview from 1992. And here's Shin Min Ah sporting a similar look during a talk show in 1994. Brown lipstick, strong eyebrows, and heavy eye makeup are part of a look that became known as the Ssen Unni look, which roughly translates to strong older sister. The main idea behind this look was to look powerful and intimidating. the end of the 1980s saw Korea transition from an authoritarian regime to democracy. Women started to enter the workforce in large numbers, and they quickly had to find ways to eradicate the image of women being vulnerable and somehow weaker than their male counterparts. In the past 2 years or so, we've seen this look making a major comeback in Korean beauty. And I believe this is partly due to the gender debate in Korea that sparked, especially after the murder case at Gangnam Station in 2016. Dark lips in particular became a hot topic around 2018, when the singer Ssen Unni was seen wearing dark lipstick throughout the promotion of her single Heroine. Shortly after, all major Korean beauty brands launched lip products in darker shades, and dark lips have been ubiquitous ever since. The singer Wasa was one of the first ones to adopt the look, and more recently we've seen artists like Idol or Red Velvet sporting dark lips in their videos and performances. Trend number 2 is brown Smokey-Eye. Another key feature of the Ssen Unni style was the brown Smokey-Eye. Brown colored shading and contouring in general were really popular in Korea in the 1990s. The main idea was to make the face look more dramatic and three-dimensional, which is something completely different from the fresh face look that we used to see in Korean beauty nowadays. Brown smokey eye in particular became a major trend after Ssen Unni was elected Miss Korea in 1992. Smokey eyes quickly became the signature look of many actresses and singers of the time, including Kim Yesu, Choi Si-ra, and Shim Eun-ha. Shim Eun-ha especially made this look popular in 1994, when she starred in a TV drama called M that was a huge hit at the time. The smokey eye trend disappeared at the end of the 90s to be replaced with a more natural and soft look. Some Korean stars like Iori or the K-pop group 2NE1 could still be seen sporting smokey eyes from time to time, but they were mostly isolated cases. Smokey eyes started to gain momentum again around 2018, when the actress Ida Hee appeared in the TV drama The Beauty Inside wearing a very 90s inspired eye makeup look. She immediately became the talk of the town within the beauty community, and many content creators started to post tutorials on how to recreate her iconic makeup from the series. Beauty companies pick on this trend right away, and in just a matter of time, lots of Korean celebrities could be spotted wearing a smokey eye. For example, here we can see a campaign by the brand Hera featuring Jennie from Blackpink. Here's the actress Han Ye-seul and Soojin from Idol in 2019. Trend number 3 is angled brows. Raise your hand if you have heard of Korean style straight eyebrows. Straight eyebrows are one of the most popular features of Korean beauty. A quick Google search will tell you that straight brows are considered ideal in Korea because they give the face a soft and youthful appearance. Which is true, you know, if we're talking about Korean beauty standards between 2011 and 2017. Straight eyebrows were not always the beauty standard in Korea. Bold angle brows, for example, were the most sought after look of the 1990s. The main goal again was to create a really strong and charismatic appearance, with a very high arch and a defined angle. These eyebrows became known as seagull eyebrows, or galmaegi nunsop in Korean. And they were popularized by actresses like Kim Yesu, Go So-young, and Choi Si-ra. Choi Si-ra in particular is usually praised by Korean makeup artists for having the most iconic eyebrows of the 1990s. It is said that many Korean women at the time used to shape the outer half of their eyebrows to be able to draw the arch as high as possible and replicate the eyebrows of Choi Si-ra. In terms of thickness, there was no real standard. In general, eyebrows used to be a lot thinner than they are now, but you could find both thin and thick eyebrows throughout the decade. The angled brow trend pretty much disappeared at the beginning of the year 2000, to be replaced with a softer and more natural look, which is what people mostly associate with Korean-style makeup nowadays. However, the tide started to change a couple of years ago when top celebrities like Seolyeon, Suzy, or Han Ye-seul started to prefer slightly arched brows over super straight ones. The release of the Korean film The Handmaiden in 2016 had a major influence on this trend. Following the global success of this film, Korea fell in love with the leading actress Kim Tae-ri, and many makeup artists and beauty creators started to replicate a soft, angled brows. Since then, eyebrows have been getting more and more angled, and it's easy to spot 90s style eagle eyebrows in beauty editorials or campaigns now. Trend number 4 is shimmer eyeshadow. As we just saw, the brown smokey eye emerged in Korea in the first half of the 1990s and went on to become the most popular look of the decade. However, there was a brief moment at the end of the 90s where the main trend was all about futuristic and cyborg aesthetics. This was reflected in clothes, hairstyles, makeup, and basically everything you can think of. In a way, this was similar to the Y2K trend that was popular in the West around the same time. Both trends originate from a sense of optimism in the new technological advancements that the new millennium would bring. It was a time when people looked at the future with hope and excitement, especially because Korea went through some really dramatic events in 1997, following what is known as the 1997 Asian financial crisis. So it was particularly important for Koreans to believe that the future would bring better days. Around this time, many pop stars started to sport cyborg-inspired makeup, featuring metallic lipsticks, shimmer eyeshadow, and lots of silver. Singers like Oh Jung-hwa and Lee Jonghyun quickly became famous for their elaborate futuristic looks. These stage makeups were hard to replicate in real life, obviously, but they inspired people to incorporate some of these elements in their daily looks. Oh Jung-hwa in particular made a huge impact in the beauty industry in 1998, when she wore shimmering powder all over her face during the promotion of her hit song Molla. And for this reason, she's usually credited for starting the trend of shimmer eyeshadow in Korean beauty. This is probably the only trend from this list that never really goes away and keeps coming back in fashion from time to time. However, I noticed that this trend has been especially big in the past 2 years. I think part of the reason is the glowing skin craze that we saw in K-beauty recently, but it can also be traced back to the popularity of the K-pop singer Jung-ha. The moment she started wearing these beautiful glowy eye makeup looks in her performances around 2018, she became the talk of the town. There was a point when pretty much everyone in the Korean beauty community was gushing about her makeup and recreating her looks. Obviously, Korean beauty brands wasted no time and jumped on the trend almost immediately, with new lines of shimmery shadow and sparkly palettes that are all about that blink. I don't even remember the last time I saw a brand coming out with matte eyeshadows, to be honest. Trend number 5 is chunky highlights. Lastly, I want to talk about chunky highlights, or as Koreans call it, bridge dyeing. Chunky highlights became really popular in the second half of the 1990s and were especially associated with girl groups like SES or Pink and boy bands like Jackskis. The person who's credited for first starting this trend is the actress Kim Hee-sun. To be honest, most of the Korean hair trends from the 1990s can be traced back to Kim Hee-sun. She's responsible for the super straight middle part hairstyle, for the hairpin trend, the headband trend, the scrunchie trend, the low ponytail. Basically, whatever she did with her hair at the time, it became a huge trend. The chunky highlights in particular became famous in 1997 when she appeared in a TV drama called Propose, sporting these iconic bright red highlights. This hairstyle was really loved by high school students because it was an easy way to experiment with the hair without commitment, and also because at the time students were not allowed to dye their hair, so teenagers that wanted to be a little bit rebellious used to color only one or two strands because it was easy to hide them. Since last year, chunky highlights had a major comeback. We've seen them on Ryujin from ITZY, Minnie from Idol, and Yerin from 여자친구. In this case, it's difficult to pinpoint exactly who was the first person to bring back this trend. However, there's one person that created quite a stir last year when they got highlights, and it's Jungkook from BTS. The moment he got highlights last November, he was pretty much on everyone's mouth. with Korean netizens comparing him to first-generation K-pop legends like H.O.T. I think part of the reason is that his current haircut is also quite similar to the classic boy band hairstyle from the 1990s that people used to call curtain haircut. And that was it. These were the top 5 Korean beauty trends from the 1990s that are currently making a comeback. If there's anything that you think I missed out, let me know in the comments below. I really hope that you liked this video. I put a lot of effort in researching the contents and putting together something that could be informative and entertaining at the same time. If you enjoyed today's video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you next time!